after all competition, Helen Catchway of 72 kilograms. And off this side, making his way to the cage and into the blue corner. Put your hands together for Nick Foster!
Yeah, this fight for me is one I'm excited about. Coming from a boxing background myself, I love to see the guys coming over from boxing to MMA. Joshua Bakhbakhi has done that. I'm expecting some big things.
Well, now that you mentioned Josh Bakhbakhi, he is a silver medalist for Britain, and he also boxed for Wales, so he's got a definite pedigree. And now we're going to see how Nick Foster, who I believe I've seen before, and if he's the same guy, this guy is no joke. Now, Nick Foster will have an edge in experience. He's got 7 bouts versus Bakhbakhi's 3. So we'll see if that
now,
plays.
Bakhbakhi, as I said, I came, you know, from a boxing background. Having that sort of experience of preparation for the boxing fights is the same as coming and preparing for the MMA. And he'll have had many, many fights boxing for England, for Wales, sorry.
Big shot, takes him down to the ground, follows up
that.
With some ground and pound. And he's really throwing down them hammer fists. Good tie up there by Nick Foster.
He needs to get some room to put the actual power into those shots.
Now look at this, Bakhbakhi is trying to throw shots at any given opening. He's gonna look to maybe possibly pass guard, he's straightening the leg out. However, Foster is keeping him tied up with that overhand headlock.
Now what he needs to do is make space first so he can power down the shots from up on high rather than just chopping him in from that low guard. He's in the half guard, all he needs to do is clear that hand from behind his head. I don't think he needs to worry too much about passing the guard, Pierre, from here.
If he postures up, uses bicep control, he can actually sit on his legs, crossed fashion, and it actually locks the half guard down, and he'll be able to throw some heavy, heavy shots from that position.
I sometimes find it easier to fire the big, heavy shots in from half guard than I do when I'm inside control, because you can just keep them locked in.
Now, let's just remember, Josh Bakhbakhi is coming from Jave's gym. It's a traditional Thai boxing gym with mixed martial arts. So, and again, he's making his what? fourth showing, so he's still learning the technical aspects of the groundwork.
So they can see the power in those shots. Nick Foster still staying fairly relaxed on the bottom to say he's took them heavy blows.
Both guys are just pretty much jockeying for position right now. Nick Foster has been in this position before. He's not showing any real frustration at this point. However, he doesn't want to be there.
He does need to work to re-guard, I think, Pierre. You know, like I said, that half guard is not a good place to be.
Now, he could use a lockdown that was made famous by Eddie Bravo, working sweeps or reversals, or he could try to throw the hips out and shrimp out and maybe regain guard.
Yeah, I think a lockdown can be quite dangerous, Pierre, from the bottom in MMA, because you are locking yourself into that position. That's the first time we've seen Bakhbakhi really get postured up and get some shots in. I'd like to see him just clearing the head, cross-facing the head, and getting some real leverage into his shots, as we've seen earlier in the night.
Now, as you mentioned, when he crowds himself, he crowds his punches, then it's arm punches. However, when he postures up, he makes that distance to really try to generate some momentum on those shots. Now, he's still looking to actively pass guard.
Right, let's see what we can get now. Bakhbakhi decides, stand back up, let's see what shots I can land.
Now, Nick Foster is a southpaw, and he just got clipped with that overhand left hook. Big right hook comes over the top. Nick Foster eats another left hook. Bakhbakhi is really trying to take this fight over.
Throwing the kicks there to show he's not just a boxer, he's not any one-trick pony.
Now, at Nick Foster's corner, what will you tell him if it makes it to the second round?
You know what? Bakhbakhi's committing himself a little much with the throws, you know, he's throwing looping left hooks, looping right hands. I'd be sure saying to Nick Foster, stay relaxed, keep tight, and fire that straight shot down the middle. You see that southpaw jab there?
Now, Nick Foster, I'd like to see him keep his lead leg to the outside of Bakhbakhi's and throw that straight left down the pipe. That's textbook fighting for a southpaw.
Yeah, certainly. But I think he's doing a good job here with that counter jab. You know, Bakhbakhi's coming in a bit too committed with his left hook and his right hand. There you go, there's the straight shots. That's what he needs to do, Pierre.
Keep it long, because so far Bakhbakhi has been scoring off that looping hook. Yeah. Now remember, a straight line beats a looping hook every time, but you've got to have good timing and the ability to throw it.
That's right, and he needs to keep nice and tight because he is susceptible to that left hand over the top. Especially, there's a big difference when you're throwing boxing and working boxing with these little gloves on because you cannot protect your face the same.
Now, I give that round to Bakhbakhi with just the dominant performance on the ground control with the short shots as well as the stand-up. Now, Bakhbakhi, his work ethic, not work ethic, but his work rate slowed down towards the end of the first. He's got to be very careful that he doesn't blow in the end of the first and beginning of the second. So I look for a better pace.
Yeah, certainly. I think he maybe came out a bit overexcited, started settling to it. He realized Nick Foster's not just going to roll over, Pierre. He's there to fight.
Oh, without a doubt. Nick Foster has been here before, been to the big show. He actually fought a tournament style at Knuckle Up, Stand Your Ground, and he won his first bout, lost the second bout. But he said, you know what? His style is MMA, so he's ready for this, and he wants to show the fans here at Exmouth. Don't look for Nick Foster, as you say. He's not going to roll over for this guy or the next guy.
Certainly not, and I think his confidence will grow as he's come through. You know, he got caught with some heavy shots, but he came through it. He's got his minutes rest now, listening to his corner, listening to the instructions. I think he's going to come out better for this second round, Pierre.
And I will say one thing about Josh Bakhbakhi, though. He throws punches with mean intentions.
He certainly does.
Nick Foster, when we were at the XL Center, he showed a high level of skill on the ground. So far, it's been negated by Josh Bakhbakhi, that strong control. Let's see if Nick Foster is able to make something happen, either on the stand-up or on the ground here in the second.
There you see that jab there, the counter jab. It's working for Nick Foster.
Woo!
He needs to not get too carried away, though. He is fighting against someone with boxing experience.
You've got to have confidence in your guard, hands up, especially against a boxer. Wild kick there by Bakhbakhi, missing the mark.
This is great stand-up by both guys. You know, backwards, forwards, you've got the hook coming over the top, Bakhbakhi, and then you've got this nice, sharp southpaw counter jab.
Now, every time Foster throws that hook, Bakhbakhi comes over with the leaping left hook. Why not feint the jab, catch him on the way in with that leaping left hook?
Yeah. So then come back with a straight left.
Exactly. But he's got to be able to identify that, and that's what his corner. Ooh, huge uppercut. I tell you what, if he would have connected with that, we'd be looking for his gum shield in the next county.
So I think he was trying to take his head off there, Pierre.
Good inside leg kick there.
I like those kicks. That can just really put you off coming in. See, they're mixing it up as well. That's what you need to do, Pierre, mixing it up and down.
Now, as soon as you start attacking the leg, you start messing with the other fighter's mobility.
Yeah, his ability to set his feet as well. You know, he can't set his feet for that counter jab if he's been hit with the inside leg kick first.
Now, Nick Foster, his hands are dangerously low, especially when Babaki's coming over with those looping hooks. He's going to have to make sure, again, he's getting tagged left and right. However, good head work, trying to move off the power. Look at the punch combinations there by Bakhbakhi.
That's one shot landed there, Pierre.
However, let's not take anything away from Foster. Look at the head movement. He really, really nullified a lot of the punches thrown there by Bakhbakhi.
It's a real testament to the fitness of Foster, how quickly he recovered from that headshot. It's your fitness that makes you recover from the shots like that, Pierre.
I'll tell you what, both of these guys, in my book, studs. They've taken leather, given leather, and they're still there.
Well, they're doing the job properly. They're entertaining the guys at home here, Pierre. The crowd here going wild. We've seen some great stand-up. Neither of these guys too really keen to take it to the floor.
Which is a surprise for me, because I'm going to tell you what, the first time Bakhbakhi hit me with any one of those hooks, I'm taking it straight to the floor.
Yeah, but I think Nick Foster, if anything, is growing in confidence as this fight's progressing.
Good head movement. He's not stationary. Good footwork. He's working angles, looking to come up over the top of possible a wild hook there by Bakhbakhi. You know what? This is turning out to be a nice fight.
But Bakhbakhi's looking quite tired. He's not coming in as much. He's breathing heavily. Foster's still moving around, flicking out that jab.
Oh, big overhand right and lands on the button. Foster's still on his feet. That is a testament, again, to his diehard will to stay in this bout.
There was a Steven Seagal front kick. Landed short.
Made famous by Anderson Silva.
But I think what Bakhbakhi's doing now is being a bit more conservative with his shots. He's picking them and waiting, because that was he waited for that right hand, but when he threw it and meant it.
And I think that's smart, because you can't keep up that way. I mean, you can, but for the average guy, that's going to take a lot out of you.
And we could do it, Pierre, but for the average guy at home.
Oh, exactly. They don't call you M16 for nothing. Huge punch barrage again, and he puts Foster onto the floor, following
up. Nice combination here, Pierre.
Look at the face of Bakhbakhi, just the mean intentions and the intensity. He wants that win, and he will not let Nick Foster stand in his way. Ladies and gentlemen, if you can hear the thumps.
Yeah, it's over. That is over. That was the right decision there from referee Nathan Webb. Maybe 10, 15 unanswered shots there, Pierre.
And fighter safety, again, in any organization, this is a sport. This isn't your average fight on the street. We're looking for fighter safety. Good call from the referee, and you expect nothing less from the third man in the cage. Bakhbakhi, 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 Bakhbakhi.
Well, I've got to say, an absolute powerhouse. It's great to have you on the show. Please give up for Knuckle Up.